author and founder of Health Plus Wellness Centers. Brothers, we are blessed to have this morning Dr. Joe Esposito and his lovely assistant, Laura. Would you welcome Dr. Joe?
Thank you, sir. Morning, all.
Good morning.
Hey, everybody's up and awake, yeah. Okay. I'm Dr. Joe, as he was saying. Real quick, my background, I'm board certified in chiropractic, I'm board certified in orthopedics, I'm double board certified in nutrition, I have a BS in clinical nutrition, retired dietitian, award-winning author, internationally syndicated radio show host. Been in practice over 30 years. I've missed a half a day of work in 30 years because I hit my head and I was dizzy and the staff sent me home. And so what we're going to talk about today is, I was going to talk about the seven deadly sins in nutrition, telling you guys what we need to eat and not eat. Then I wanted to also add in at men's health, because obviously it's all men here, so we can talk about issues that we have. Usually when I'm with a group, it's mixed group, and you know, I don't want to talk about something that somebody's not interested in, but all of us have men issues. And unfortunately, we don't get addressed too often. If you ever watch the TV shows, it's a lot of women's health and women's issues, and what can women do? What about hormones? What about us? You know, we got issues too. And so we're going to talk about that today, and it's really going to be enlightening for you. It's really going to change your life. So when I got invited, I was very happy that Walton invited me, and I started thinking, what I do and what you do, how do we tie it all together? Well, you're dealing with the spiritual aspects, but we also have to deal with the physical and the chemical. At this point, we got physical and chemical stuff we have to deal with. And there's a great line from a band called Emerson, Lake and Palmer. I don't know if any of you are old enough to remember that. You are, right?
Yeah.
Okay. And it was a great line. And the line was, you don't have to be well to be wealthy, but you've got to be whole to be holy. That's important. I want you to get that for a second. Because you can be rich, okay? You don't have to be healthy, but if you want to be spiritually whole, it has to be the physical, the spiritual, the mental, the chemical, and that's what we're going to cover today. I'm going to handle the scientific parts of it, okay? So, there are seven foods that I want you to consider taking out of your diet. The good news is, there's 120,000 that you can eat. That's a fair deal, right? All right, here's the deal. I'm going to give you...
I haven't heard the others.
Grass, dirt, carpet. So anyway, if I'm going to give you $120,000, I want $7 back, no strings attached. Good deal?
Yeah, good deal.
Do I not want that deal? No. So the good news is I'm going to give you way, way more than I'm going to ask you to consider cutting back or cutting out of your diet. If you do it for 30 days. If I'm wrong, so what? But if I'm right, I am. Everything will change in your life. Your personal life, your business life, your love life, your spiritual life, everything changes. And if I'm wrong, so what? You save a couple of bucks on food. It's a fair deal, right? Okay. So, well, there's actually eight. If you smoke, you can pretty much ignore what I'm going to say. You got to quit that. So hopefully nobody here smokes. If you do, I do a whole lecture on addiction because food is we have a lot of food addiction. Cigarettes are addiction. Drugs are addictions. And it's a chemical reaction that occurs in the brain. Certain things stimulate the dopamine receptor sites in your brain. Dopamine is a chemical in your brain, a neurotransmitter that gets you high, makes you feel good. And we all want to feel good. And so when you do things, even though you know it's wrong, you do it anyway. What's that called? Sin, right? But there's a chemical reaction that occurs. And if we can start dealing with the chemistry in the brain, you're able to deal with a lot of these things. So, seven deadly sins, you ready? Want to hear?
Yeah.
Okay, good. You may be mad. No. Alcohol, meat, sugar, dairy, coffee, soda, and artificial sweetener. That's everything. There you go. Wayne just said, that's everything. I quit. Why live? That's right.
What's live?
It's in the note. I'm going to give you a copy of the notes, and the notes will have everything in it, so you don't have to write it down. Okay, it's alcohol, meat, sugar, dairy, coffee, soda, artificial sweetener. But you're all very intelligent people here, so I'm going to play on your intellect. Because when somebody brings up something, even if you don't agree with it, you think about it, you go, holy frank, I hate that. And I'll be right. But I'm going to negotiate every one of them. How about that?
That'll work.
All right? I'll negotiate with you. Fair enough? Okay. Alcohol. Let's start with alcohol. Alcohol destroys what?
Brain cells.
How many people do that? How many people forgot that?
Too much alcohol.
Just checking. So alcohol destroys brain cells. Your brain controls what? Everything. Everything that happens, you see me, you're hearing me, you're sitting there, you're chewing gum, you're scratching your head, your toenails are growing. Everything happens because the brain has to tell it what to do. And your brain sits up here, right? In most cases. And your brain sends messages down your spine, out your nerves, to every cell in the body. So right now, there's a nerve going to your arms, your legs, and your spleen, and your prostate, and your kidneys, and earwax. Everything has to have a nerve going to it. Alcohol destroys the part that sends the message. A little bit of alcohol, a little bit of brain damage. A lot of alcohol, a lot of brain damage. And you think to yourself, but that's no big deal, Dr. Joe. I have just a glass of beer, a glass of wine every now and then, or some beer every now and then. Understand that. Your body can process a little bit of toxin. It can't process a lot of toxin. And the thing is that when you sit down and really think about it, what I have all my patients do is this. I have them write down everything they eat. No lying. And they write it down and they come in and half my job is done already. Because as they hand in their diet, they go, wow, I didn't realize what I was doing. I hardly ever have beer except Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Friday, Saturday, wine on Sunday. So alcohol destroys brain cells, brain controls everything. Now, there is a good alcohol, right? There's certain alcohols good for your heart. What's that?
Red wine.
Red wine, exactly. Why not white wine? Why not vodka? Why not beer? Why not scotch? It's not the wine that's good for you. It's the red that's good for you. The grapes have chemicals in it called proanthocyanidines and antioxidants. And these are good for you. However, it's not coming from the wine, it's coming from grapes. It happened to be in the wine. So good excuse, you know? And when we study the Bible, we talk about wine in the Bible a lot, right? It's not the same wine. They had to come up with a way to preserve grapes. So they juiced it and fermented it and then watered it down. It was like a little bit of wine with a whole lot of water. We're drinking a whole lot of wine with no water. Big difference in the type of wine that we're talking about here, okay? So, if we're going to drink wine, I told you to negotiate everything, right? Cut your deal here, all right? If we're gonna drink wine, it's gotta be organic. The reason is, when you and I were kids, we wouldn't be having this conversation. The word organic, really, it was used for other things. It had nothing to do with food, because everything was organic, right? Remember the old days? Peaches were juicy. Peaches. Watermelon was sweet.
Yeah.
Milk had something in it. What was it? Flavor. Remember that? Remember milk had flavor in it? Now it's meh. Milk would separate. Cream on the top. Yeah. Bugs in it. That's a good milk. Okay. Now we pasteurize it, homogenize it, and the cows ate grass back then. Now the cows eat soybeans and corn. Cows are not designed to eat soybeans and corn. In nature, they're not going to go, soybeans. I think we'll eat them. Cows say, well, I'm going to eat grass. That's what they're naturally attracted to. That's what their digestive system is designed to do. And then we do something else with our soybeans and our corn now. We do something called genetic modification. Yes. GMO, genetically modified organisms. And when you genetically modify corn or soy, you change the molecular structure, the DNA, the protein changes. So now you as a human being have never seen this protein structure before. So your body doesn't know what to do with it. It's a new protein. And we're finding now, because it's been out long enough for long-term studies, we're starting to see people have allergic reactions. Sterility, impotence, mood swings, weight gain from eating these genetically modified foods. So 30 years ago, when I used to do talks on nutrition, we talked about calories. Calories have been gone to the wayside now. Because now you can eat something with 0 calories and gain weight. And you can eat something with 1,000 calories and not gain weight. It's the type of calories. And genetically modified food is a different new protein, and our body doesn't know how to deal with it. And why do we genetically modify it? So that we can spray weed killer on it. It's something called glyphosate. You use it in your garden every day. If you have the standard weed killer that you have, but they spray it in megatons on the corn and the soy. So you're eating the cows who ate the corn and the soy who ate the concentrated glyphosate, which gets into their fat cells. You're eating the fat cells, because that's what the good stuff is, the fat. And you start getting all these toxic buildups in your body. And we start seeing a lot of things different than was when we were kids. One of the things, so you'll notice the kids, aren't they maturing a little faster than they did when we were kids?
Yep.
I mean, you know, you got little 5-year-old girls and 8-year-old girls and 11-year-old girls looking mature. And what I'm seeing with boys, first of all, I don't know if anybody played football when they were a kid. Okay. You notice the kids are a lot bigger than you were? Yeah. I mean, I look at these high school football players. I was 210, 210 pounds in high school, biggest guy on my team. I look at these 210 doesn't even play anymore. That's like a kicker, you know, 210. These kids are so much bigger. And notice this, men's health, men are starting to develop breasts. It's called gynecomastia. Look at the young boys, they're starting to develop breasts, even if they're muscular, because they're putting hormones in their body that are estrogen-like compounds. And this affects us too. These estrogen-like compounds are getting into our body, counteracting our testosterone, and feminizing the men.
Wow.
Interesting.
Wow.
When I first started in practice, every now and then a guy would come in, and he'd talk about sexual impotence, malfunction, doc, I can't work like I used to. It's usually old guys. Remember those old guys when they were like 50? Remember that was old, right? Now you think, I have socks older than that. But now we're having kids coming in 20, 25 years old with sexual dysfunction. And a lot of it, I believe, is due to the exposure of all these synthetic chemicals that we're exposing ourselves and our kids to. So it's a big issue, okay? So we have to be careful what we put in our body. So if we're gonna eat meat, let's go back to alcohol, I'm sorry. I kind of wandered away there for a second. Okay, alcohol destroys brain cells, your brain controls everything. If you're gonna drink wine, it's gotta be organic. Because if you want the benefits for your heart, it has to be organic grapes, because when we spray these pesticides on the grape, we spray antifungal chemicals. Now, try to follow me on this, it's not hard. When grapes are exposed to fungus, they produce something called resveratrol. Resveratrol is a chemical that prevents the grapes from being eaten by the fungus. So if you're gonna eat organic wine, you're gonna get resveratrol. If the grapes have been sprayed, they don't have to produce resveratrol anymore. They don't have to fight off the fungus. So now all the benefits are out the window. So if I'm gonna drink wine, it's gotta be organic or just eat grapes. Well, that's an idea. Just eat grapes, preferably organic, of course. Making sense? Alcohol is also diuretic. Diuretic means what?
Lose water.
Makes you pee, right?
Yeah.
You ever notice I drink one beer, you pee out three? Where does other three beers come from? Because your body is so smart that when it's exposed to a chemical that can destroy the brain, it wants to flush it out of the system before it gets to the brain. So your body in its infinite wisdom says, you can't put that in here because the alcohol destroyed my brain cells. You gotta go pee. Then you dehydrate. Then you wake up the next morning with a headache and a hangover. Your brain shrinks. So here's my negotiation for you. Okay, it's all for you, Wayne. I'm doing this all for you, okay? If you drink, for every drink you have, 3 glasses of water. Can we do that? It's not hard, right? You'll save a ton of money, first of all. You won't be buying as much booze. And you'll be peeing, so you won't have time to drink as much. But we gotta rehydrate the body. That's the key when it comes to alcohol. Okay? Preferably don't, but if you do, very little amounts, 3 glasses of water. Fair enough? Gonna be wine. Oh, by the way, the heart benefits from the wine, the resveratrol, the red grapes, the organic red grapes have it. You have to drink about a case of wine a day. That's not permission to do that now.
I don't drink. But okay.
They can't see you on the camera, so they don't know who you are. Okay. Wayne's really tall, good looking. Case of wine a day to get the medicinal benefits of red wine for the resveratrol. So, it's kind of a good marketing tool, okay? But I really prefer you don't do that. Okay, so alcohol. What else? Sugar gives you what? Energy, right? It's on TV, must be true. Right? You have soda in the morning, get all this energy. Chew gum, you get energy. Sugar doesn't give you energy, it actually robs the body of energy. And when we talked about calories, and bad calories, and good calories, if I gave you 100 calories of pure sugar, or 100 calories of organic coconut oil. The coconut oil is not going to put weight on you. The sugar will. And what happens is when you put sugar in your body, let's talk about the immune system for a second for us boys. You got an immune system. It's working right now. It's doing its thing. And what happens is one immune cell will kill off about 14 germs. I give you sugar, a can of soda. That one immune cell can now kill off one germ. Talk about blowing out your immune system. And what do we eat all day, every day?
Sugar.
Exactly. Breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Now, when I say sugar, not just table sugar, breads, cookies, cakes, donuts, pastas, sugar. So that's bad. So I want you to think about this. No more breads, cookies, cakes, donuts, and pastas. Is that going to be hard?
Yeah.
It'll take you 3 days to get over the addiction. That's the cool part. Go 3 days without any processed sugar. Breads, cookies, cakes, donuts, pastas, processed sugar, white sugar, soda. 3 days. By the fourth day, you'll get over it. But there's a problem. You're going to get tempted. And when you are, you're going to say, I've been really good lately. I want to have a cookie. I'm going to have some bread. If I gave you bread, what do you want more?
Bread.
You see how the addiction kicked in instantly? You didn't even have to think about it. So the problem is, as soon as you go back to it, you're going to want more and more and more and more because it's stimulating the dopamine receptor sites in your brain. Dopamine is the neurotransmitter that gives you pleasure. And sugar is the quickest, easiest, cheapest, legal way to get high. And that's why we do it all day, every day. Good. Now, a couple years ago, we came out with something that's called high fructose corn syrup. When you were a kid, soda was made with sugar. Now soda's made with high fructose corn syrup. Let's talk about boy stuff now. How could high fructose corn syrup affect boy stuff? You put a high fructose corn syrup in your body, anything more than 25 grams goes into your liver and gets converted into something called uric acid. Uric acid is famous for what disease?
Gout.
Hurts, gets in your joints and it hurts. I'm a chiropractor. I'm a pain management expert. I deal with patients in pain every day. There's not a day that goes by that I'm not either emailing, talking to somebody, and seeing patients in pain 365 days a year. So you can come to me and I can give you my team of doctors. I have 5 doctors in my offices. I can give you the best chiropractic care in the world. But if you're eating high fructose corn syrup, you're producing uric acid, which is getting into joints and causing pain. What does this have to do with guy stuff? Uric acid prevents the body from producing nitric oxide. Nitric oxide is a vasodilator. It opens up your blood vessels. Little blue pills, they open up blood vessels. You're eating high fructose corn syrup, constricting those blood vessels. And now it's not just the sex organs that are going to be affected. How about your blood pressure? It goes up. Vessels are smaller, blood pressure goes up. How about brain function? How about energy levels? How about muscle mass? Everything starts to shut down when you stop producing nitric oxide. So every time you want to have processed breads, cookies, cakes, donuts, pastas, and soda with high fructose corn syrup, you're shutting down your male function, but also your human function. The brain, the muscles, the blood flow. So think about that. You want to stop and have a soda on the way home. No big deal. I need some caffeine. Give me some energy, man. Give me a cola. But what happens is, and I'll cover caffeine in a second. What happens is, high fructose corn syrup gets into your body, you're less of a man on many different levels. Now, you don't have to be well to be wealthy. You've got to be whole to be holy. And I want you to be a better father, brother, churchgoer, pastor. Whatever you do in life as a man, I want you to do it better. And by eating high fructose corn syrup, you're going to do it worse. So, high fructose corn syrup is pretty bad. Okay. But that's not the worst. It gets worse. A couple years ago, we came out with artificial sweeteners, right? 0 calories. Must be good. Studies show that the more diet soda you drink, the more weight you gain. Okay? So of all the things I'll ever teach you, the worst thing you can put in your body is artificial sweetener. Okay? So today at breakfast, I stole a packet of artificial sweetener. And I want to show you what happens when this gets into your body. I'm going to tell you what it is first, and I'm not going to have anybody eat it. Don't worry, I like you guys. But I'm just going to show you an amazing example as to what happens when you put it in your body, okay? This is aspartame. Aspartame breaks down to three components. Follow me on the chemistry. If you get lost, don't worry about it. Aspartame breaks down to aspartic acid, phenylalanine, and methyl esters. Aspartic acid is an excitotoxin to the brain. What that means is it causes your brain to fire faster than it's supposed to and can literally burn out your brain cells. Your brain controls what?
Everything.
There you go. So aspartic acid is an excitotoxin to the brain, just like monosodium glutamate, glutamic acid, and aspartic acid are excitotoxins to the brain, burns out your brain cells. Phenylalanine, if you have a problem processing phenylalanine, you might have a disease called phenylketonuria, it's pretty rare, but if you drink artificial sweetener, you can die, because the kidneys can't process out the phenylalanine. And then it breaks down into methyl esters. Methyl esters is methanol. Methanol is what? Wood alcohol. So you're drinking alcohol. And it was an interesting thing that led me down this path. I was invited several years ago to an Alcoholics Anonymous meeting, an AA meeting. Walked into the meeting. First of all, four of my patients were there. How do I explain why I'm at the AA meeting? But I was amazed that a lot of skinny people were drinking soda, but not regular soda, diet soda. I thought, why are these people drinking diet soda? Well, for the caffeine, but they're skinny, why don't they drink regular soda? So that's when I started my research into the chemistry. Methyl esters is methanol. Methanol is wood alcohol. They're getting drunk at the AA meeting. Wow. And I went to the guy at the AA meeting and I said, listen, I said, you need to give me 5 minutes. There's a big crowd, three times the size of this crowd probably at the meeting. And I said, you got to give me 5 minutes. I have to tell them what they're doing. He says, you can't speak. You're not an alcoholic.
Right.
And I went, wait a minute. Wait here. And I thought that was just, I understand the rules and I follow the rules, but I thought that was insane. Because they need to hear the story. So now you're hearing it, so you can pass it on to your friends and yourself too. So artificial sweetener, aspartic acid, phenylalanine, methyl esters becomes methanol, methanol becomes formaldehyde. Formaldehyde is why? Embalming fluid. It's a class A carcinogenic, which means it's the worst of the worst. Okay, so of all the things I'll ever teach you, this is the worst. Okay? Now, what happens is you can eat it, but I want to show you how powerful this stuff is. Your skin is a sponge. Anything that comes in contact with your skin is going to get absorbed. I have a new book coming out. I just finished the last edits this week. And I talk about that pretty extensively. So I talk about anything you put on your skin. So it's shaving cream, shampoo, colognes, deodorants, perfumes. They get absorbed into your skin. And so if you're putting toxic chemicals on your skin, it's getting into your body. So here's the rule on anything you put on your body. If you would eat it and get sick, you shouldn't put it on your body. Okay, now, you wouldn't eat shampoo, but there are natural shampoos that if you ate would taste terrible, but you wouldn't get sick. Deodorants, antiperspirants have aluminum in it. Aluminum can be absorbed and get into the brain. The brain controls what?
Everything.
Aluminum can get into your brain and short circuit your brain. We see a suspected link between Alzheimer's and aluminum consumption. You think, I don't eat aluminum. Antiperspirants. On my website, I have a recipe to make your own deodorant. Now, I know that sounds weird, but it's real simple. Shea butter, coconut oil, tea tree oil, and baking soda. Double boil it, melt it up, mix it together, put it in a container, let it cool down, rub it under your arms. Works great, non-toxic, and it's actually good for you. Because shea butter is good for your skin. Coconut oil has lauric acid in it. Lauric acid stimulates your immune system. You know where else we find lauric acid? Breast milk. So coconut oil has similar components as breast milk for stimulating the immune system. So here I'm giving you something that's good for you and cheaper than what you're using right now. A little weird?
Yeah.
I'm going to give you a lot of stuff today. Some of you will use some of it. Some of you will do all of it. Most of you will do some of it. And some of you will do none of it. But that's okay. Because this is the first time you're hearing this stuff. And I know it's going to, your brain explodes. But you'll get it. Trust me. If you walk away with one little fact, I did my job today. And you're going to walk away a lot more than that. Okay, so anything you put on your skin gets absorbed. Okay? So I want to show you how toxic this is. Can I use you? You don't mind being on camera? All right, come on up here. All right. So, make it official. There we go. All right, turn to face the crowd. Put your arms straight out. Why is that happening? That way.
Yeah.
Don't say it. All right, push your arm up real hard.
Oh, let me put this down.
Push up real hard.
Wow.
Push up again. You have somebody weak and sickly, maybe, I think. All right, so I took this from the cafeteria, right? Put your hand out. I'm not having you eat it, I'm just having you hold it. Wrap your hand around it, okay? So what we're doing is I'm letting this be absorbed into his skin. Not making him eat it. But anything that gets onto your body can absorb in about 10 or 15 seconds. That's why if you have drugs on patches, he absorbed into the body. So your skin is a sponge, and I want to show you what happens if you eat, and he's eating it. He's holding it, right? So theoretically, if I weighed this when he was done, it should be exactly the same weight. A little bit gets absorbed. But remember we said aspartic acid is a neurotoxin to the brain. Brain controls everything. Put your arms straight out. Push up as hard as you can.
Oh, wow.
Push up again. Okay, who sees to his car? Okay, here we go. Ready? Push up real hard. Isn't that wild? Ooh, yeah. Trash can back there. Wow. He didn't eat it.
Wow.
He held it. Every muscle in his body went weak. And in theory, it's about the same weight. He didn't absorb hardly anything. What would happen if you had a diet soda today? Or sugar-free gum?
Wow.
I was looking for gum the other day, not for me. Somebody wanted me to buy them gum. Could not find a gum made with sugar. Every one of them had artificial sweetener. So you think you're doing your kids a favor? There you go, Johnny, here's a little gum for you. You've been a good kid. Here's some sugar-free mints. You've been a good kid. Here's some diet soda. Okay, he's checking it. Yep, there you go. I can test you with that if you want. Want me to test you with that?
Yeah.
Come on up here. Come on, come on.
All right.
Let's see here. All right, let's see. Make sure we got all the poisons in here. I believe it's made with sugar. This one might be made with sugar, but I'll show you anyway. Okay, because I don't see the artificial sweetener warning on here. It says if you have phenylketonuria, don't eat this. That means it has artificial sweetener. Okay, so this is just sugar. Drop straight out. Wow, he's got his arm. Push up real hard. Wow, pull-ups on his arm. So I think this is just sugar. Chew it up. So I think we found one. It doesn't have artificial sweetener. Oh, wait, there it is. Nope, artificial sweetener. Now, you're chewing it, sure go, right? I didn't take it from you, right? Okay, I gotta give you a second to get it into the body. It gets absorbed faster into the mouth, too, which is kind of cool. So you're just chewing a piece of gum, you think you're totally innocent, you got a little fresh breath, I want to smell nice, okay? Ready? Put your arm up. Push up real hard.
You did.
Push up.
Wow.
Want some gum?
Okay.
Wow. Oh, break the trash. He's a big boy. Hey, everybody start the trash.
Wow.
I couldn't pay him to give you that look, could I? Get his wallet now, he's moving. So that's what happens. I want you to see what happens when you put food in your body. You think it's totally innocent. It's just gum, it's just a soda, it's just a snack. No. And we as men have to be the leaders of our families. And if you're giving this to your kids, your wives, your girlfriends, your churchgoers, not a good thing, is it? Okay, so you learned a real valuable lesson there. That's not just food. Okay, do it. It works great with kids, by the way. Do that, test your kids. It's not a trick, you can do it. Push, see how strong they are, put it in their mouth, muscle blows out. And kids are going, wow. And they'll forget, after a week or two, do it again. We have to hear something 11 times in order for us to remember it. So that works with your kids too. 11 times, go over and over and over and see what happens. Pretty cool stuff. So think about that next time you want to put a toxin in your body. Any of the seven deadly sins I talked about, that muscle, that test would work on, by the way. That's why I call them the seven deadly sins of nutrition. See? Okay, so off an artificial sweetener, covered sugar, covered high fructose corn syrup. So what do we sweeten things with? I like sweet things. Honey is good, but honey has a lot of fructose in it, so a little bit at a time is okay. But here's the thing with honey, make sure it's locally grown. Yeah. And make sure it's cloudy. That clear honey, it's been filtered, and chances are they fed the bees high fructose corn syrup. Because it's cheap. And it's sweeter than sugar. I think it's like 12 times sweeter than sugar. So it's cheaper and sweeter. If I'm manufacturing something, I want to use that. I want to make money. I'm a smart manufacturer. I'm a capitalist. How can I make more money? High fructose corn syrup. People buy more of it because it stimulates dopamine receptor sites. I save money, and I sell more product. It's good capitalism. It's not good consumerism. It's good capitalism. Okay. So honey is okay as long as it's cloudy, it's clear, it's junk. Stevia. Stevia is a sweetener. You may have never heard of it. 300 times sweeter than sugar. Perfectly safe for everyone. Has over 70 nutrients in it. So it's actually good for you, as opposed to being bad for you. Now, years ago, Coca-Cola called me up and asked me if I would do a seminar for their company. And I said, you know who I am? You sure you got the right number?
Yeah.
And they said, no, no, we know who you are. We want you in here because you're probably the number one motivational speaker in the world when it comes to health and wellness. We want you. So I walked in and I went to research and development. I had a chance to get there early and I spoke to the guys in research and development. And I said, I'm curious, why don't you use stevia as a sweetener? You're using aspartame and sucralose. Sucralose, by the way, men problems. Yeah. Sucralose stimulates your estrogen receptor sites, causes your body to essentially produce more estrogen. We have enough estrogen, boys. We don't need any more. Sucralose, yellow packet, essentially lowers your testosterone, or lowers the ratio of testosterone in your body. And the more estrogen you produce, production of estrogen creates something called aromatase. Aromatase is an enzyme that converts testosterone into estrogen. So the more estrogen we have, the more estrogen we have. Follow that? Fat cells produce estrogen. Estrogen causes you to lay down fat, which produces estrogen, which causes you to lay down fat. Follow? So the fatter we are, the fatter we get because of the estrogen. Estrogen counteracts testosterone. And testosterone isn't just for your biceps and your triceps. It's your heart, it's your sex organs, it's your blood vessels, it's your colon. Testosterone is necessary to make muscles work. And as we get older, our testosterone drops 1% per year. So if you're 50, after 20, you're 30% less than you had. That's in a healthy individual. If you're not healthy, it's substantially less. And it's not just about the sex drive, it's about the function of the muscles. Okay? So anyway, so I said to the researchers at Coke, and I said, you know, how come you don't use stevia? And his answer was, there's not enough stevia in the world to meet our needs. About 20 years ago. Now, you have new products on the market called Truvia and Purvia. You may have heard of them?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Guess who owns them?
Coca-Cola.
Coke and Pepsi. So 20 years ago, I was a soothsayer. I said, this has to happen, and it's happening now. So that's a good thing. I'm not unhappy with that. It's an extract of stevia. I'm not sure. I'd rather have the pure stevia. But either way, look where the trend is going. When major companies like Pepsi take aspartame out of their products, now they're using sucralose, which I'm not thrilled with, but the awareness was there. There's so much wrong with aspartame, let me switch over and start using something else. And so for Pepsi to totally change their formula, which they just did this year, crazy. So we put that in the Dr. Joe is Right column. We'll put that right over there, okay? Because the things I talked about 30 years ago are now coming to fruition. I said 25 years ago, margarine is horrible. About 10 years after I said that, there's a report on CNN that said the number one cause of heart disease is margarine. So the things I'm talking about now, you guys are 10, 15 years ahead of the curve just by being here today. So it's really cool. So stay away from the artificial sweeteners. Stevia is an excellent choice if you have to use something as a sweet. Okay? If you need a pen, just raise your hand and I'll have Laura bring your pen. So, stevia is a good choice for sweetener. Okay? So we covered alcohol, we covered sweeteners. Coffee? I'm scared. Got pens for everybody? Good. Okay, if you need pens, just raise your hand and we'll get them all. Because I know, it's funny. Funny. Talking about testosterone. I've been lecturing for 30 years. It takes about 20 to 25 minutes for everybody to get to where you are right now. Doesn't matter where I lecture in the world. 25 minutes, people are like, I better start writing this stuff down. This is important. And it is. So, got it? Good. Okay. So let's talk about coffee. If you drink coffee, number one important to this country. Number one important to this country is oil. What do you think number two is?
Coffee.
Of course. I had a legend of Sedale Nice, didn't I? 73% of people in this country use some type of stimulant every day? Coffee. Coffee's the number one drug that's abused in this country, or used in this country. It's caffeine. Okay? So, if you're going to drink coffee, here's the rules. Coffee, commercial coffee, is sprayed with a lot of chemicals. Can we agree with that? Okay. You know a little bit about that? Okay, Walton's nodding his head. He knows a little bit about coffee. Sprayed with a lot of chemicals. Those chemicals are hormone disrupting. We talked about testosterone and boy stuff, right? It can alter your hormone levels. One cup isn't going to kill you. How many people drink one cup, though, in a lifetime? Nobody. So if we're going to drink coffee, I recommend organic only. Can we deal with that? Here's my negotiation for you, okay? Organic only. Now, I don't drink coffee, but I understand it tastes a whole lot better than regular coffee anyway. Correct? Nodding his head again. So if you're going to drink coffee organic, where do you buy it? Anywhere. Any grocery store, you know, any big grocery store is going to have organic coffee. So get organic coffee. A better choice would be organic decaffeinated coffee. If you drink commercial decaffeinated coffee, many times it's decaffeinated with turpentine and formaldehyde. Now, my turpentine levels, they're good. I don't need any more, okay? Now, so if we're gonna drink coffee, organic coffee wouldn't use those chemicals. There are other ways to do it too, but organic decaffeinated coffee would be a great choice. Now, in my first book, I have a chapter on kicking the habit. Because some of you are addicted to coffee, and you don't want to give up your coffee. Because you can't, why you get a headache. So here's the thing, you should get the book, but if you don't, I'll give you the little thing. Get a cup of coffee, put it in front of you, and take one tablespoon every hour. What that will do is slowly start to wean you off the coffee and give you enough caffeine to get you through the headache phase. And then after about 3 or 4 days, you should be okay. Then if you want to have a cup of coffee periodically, you're going to have organic coffee, I'm perfectly fine with that. Fair enough?
Coffee's also good. What time?
How far back? I am Dr. Joe?
No. Okay.
You're the whole thing again if you want. One tablespoon every hour. Okay, there you go. Oh, it's waning now. There you go. You're waning now. You got time to be picked on. You get the second half, right? One tablespoon every hour. No cream, no sugar, just straight off like that. Okay? Because coffee's an acid. And when you put acid in your body has to neutralize that acid. The body uses calcium as its primary neutralizing agent. Now, for women, it's a big issue, osteoporosis. 30 years ago, I didn't see osteoporosis in men. I'm seeing it now almost on a daily basis in my practices. Men are coming in, we take an x-ray, the bones are thin. Uh-oh, something's wrong. Most cases, it's not that you have too little calcium, it's that you have too much acid. Acid has to be neutralized, the body uses calcium and other minerals to neutralize the acid, you use it up in calcium stores, there you go. And for me to see it, if I take an x-ray of a patient, you have to have at least 33% bone loss for it to even show up on an x-ray. So you can have 32%, it won't show up on the next one. It has to be 33 or more. And so if you're already to that level, one-third of your bone mass is gone. Not good. Coffee's an acid. A little bit. And a good diet, replacing that caffeine, you're okay. So I'm negotiating with you, okay? So I negotiated with the sweeteners, I negotiated with the alcohol, I negotiated with the coffee. Soda, we kind of covered already, artificial sweeteners. But the thing is with soda, if you have cola soda, it has phosphoric acid in it. Yeah. Phosphoric acid is an acid. We just talked about that. Robs the body of calcium. And here's the other kicker for us boys. Many times when you eat canned food, the can is lined with something called bisphenol A, or BPA. Bisphenol A is an endocrine disruptor. Know what we talked about endocrine disruptor? Lowers your testosterone, raises your estrogen. So eating canned foods can mess with your hormone and your boy parts. So now you're seeing, for the first time, cans of food saying no BPA on the label. 10 years ago, I talked about BPA. Now, it's mainstream. Pretty cool stuff. And what it also does, it lines the can so the stuff slides out of the can easier. Remember when you were a kid, you used to scrape the can out of food, now it just slides right out? That's the bisphenol A. Yeah. So you never thought about how these things have changed and why they changed. So if you're going to eat canned food, I recommend look for the label that says BPA free. Most organic foods I'm finding now, or many organic foods I should say, are going bisphenol free. And that's why I think we should consider more organic foods, because they're better for you. It's the food you ate when you were a kid. Now, I'm a little upset that we have to call a food that's not toxic a special name. And the bad stuff has a regular name. Beans, organic beans. Should be the other way around, right? Beans, toxic beans. Not how it works, though. So soda's not a good choice. If you're going to drink soda, I recommend seltzer. Okay, seltzer is better than club soda. Club soda, here's a fun fact for you. Club soda has salt in it, seltzer doesn't. That's the difference. Okay, so that's why you use club soda, you mix it with alcohol. Salt gets into your mouth, stimulates the salivary glands to produce saliva. It breaks the alcohol down, makes the alcohol taste sweeter. And so you want to drink more of it. That's why we put salt in when we bake things. Why do you put salt in a cake? That doesn't make any sense. Stimulates the salivary glands to produce saliva. Saliva has salivary amylase. Amylase breaks carbohydrates into simple carbohydrates, makes it taste sweeter. So if you're going to drink something, seltzer's the way to go. Okay? Alcohol, sugar, coffee, soda, meat and dairy. Okay, we'll keep doing some more guy stuff along the way too. Okay, meat and dairy. Don't get mad at me on this. Okay. Cow's milk. What's cow's milk made for? Cows. Baby cows. Right? Any baby cows here? Raise your paw. Oof, whatever it is. Cow's milk is made to feed a baby until it's weaned off, and then it goes into the next stage of its life. All mammals have that. For some reason, somebody decided that we should drink the milk of another mammal. How bizarre is that? I mean, how strung out was this person? First person to drink milk, right? They're probably strung out on aspartame. And there's a cow in a field, and he says, I'm going to squeeze that thing. Whatever comes out of it, put it on my cereal. And what we talked earlier, the milk we drank when we were kids is different than the milk we're drinking today, right? That milk wasn't pasteurized and homogenized. The cows ate grass, had flavor to it, had cream on it. And now it's all just white water, basically. So it's changed dramatically, so it's not the same milk that we drank 30 and 40 years ago. So here's the rule on milk. If you're going to, I've got to tell you this. Sometimes the cows get infections. Not in the southeast, but in certain parts of the country, they give the cows something called somatotrophic recombinant bovine growth hormone. What that is, it causes the cow to produce large amounts of milk. The udders become engorged with milk. And the udders can rip and tear because of so much milk. And so if the udders become ripped and tear, they become infected. What do we got to give the cows? Antibiotics. There you go. So that ends up in the milk. But you know what else ends? What else ends up in the milk? Blood and the pus from the infection. So we have guidelines on that. FDA's guidelines. No more than 750,000 pus cells or blood in 8 drops of milk. That's what makes it creamy, right? Finally got this thing. So here's the rules on milk. If we're going to drink milk, let's do organic. You can buy organic milk anywhere. I don't drink milk. I haven't had any animal products in over 30 years. I'm not asking you to be freaky like me. I've been a vegan for 30 years. I'm not asking you to be a vegan. But I am saying if we're going to make choices, we're going to negotiate, okay? Try the organic milk. You'll like it. Yes?
What about almond milk and coconut milk and that?
That's a much better choice. Almond milk, coconut milk. I like coconut milk personally. I'm a big fan of coconut milk because coconut is lauric acid, medium chain fatty acids, helps my immune system. So I like coconut milk, but coconut milk, almond milk, cashew milk, hemp milk. Not the hemp you had in college. This is a different kind of hemp, okay? So it's like, wow, I'm going to try this out. So, get the unsweetened. There you go. He said there's a lot of sugar and get the unsweetened. Okay? So it's just that simple. So that's what I use. It's relatively inexpensive. Everybody carries it. And here's the thing, when people stop using their milk, the cow's milk, and they start using the coconut milk or the soy milk or the almond milk, they say, wow, this stuff has flavor. Cow's milk doesn't anymore. So if you want to do it for nutrition, you want to do it for flavor, I don't care what motivates you. I don't care how you get here, just get here. And you'll find that you like it a lot better. In most cases, that's what most people say. I don't like soy that much. I'll eat a little bit of soy here and there, but soy milk is high in something called phytoestrogens. Phytoestrogens are plant-based estrogens. Estrogen counteracts testosterone. Remember boy stuff we're talking about? So if you're gonna do soy here and there, you're gonna have some tofu or something, it's not the end of the world. But on a regular basis, it can be overpowering to our hormones, especially as we get older. Okay? So I would stay away from that. So cow's milk, probably not your best choice. And that goes for butter, cheese, ice cream, yogurt. Wouldn't do it. Okay? I haven't done it in 30 years. So far, so good. I'm gonna give it about another 100 years, and then I may go back. I'm not sure. Thinking about it. So that's dairy products. And we're gonna have a lot of questions at the end, so start thinking about your questions. Meat. We're not carnivores. We're not really designed to eat meat. Carnivores have fangs here. They have very strong jaw. They have some way to trap the meat, and they can rip the raw flesh off the carcass. That's a true carnivore. We don't have that capability. Now again, I'm not saying you have to give up meat. I'm just saying that this is what happens.
Do you ever seen Hannibal?
Hannibal? Okay, yeah. He made it with the Chianti, though, yes. The fava beans. And it's interesting. Here's a fun fact about that movie, because I know a lot of useless stuff. The medication that Hannibal was on in that movie is altered to cause damage to the brain. The only two contraindications for that medication, Chianti and fava beans. So if you ever watch that movie, he says, I ate his liver with fava beans and Chianti. They were making a statement that by eating that, it made him more crazy. But that's a side note. That has nothing to do with anything. So where does that come from? Where does this knowledge come from? So our digestive system is very long. We eat a piece of meat. It takes a while to get through. It takes about 72 hours from time in to time out for a piece of meat for somebody who has a low-fiber diet. A carnivore, dogs, cats, lions, tigers, they'll eat the meat, swallow it whole, they don't chew it, you'll notice, because their stomach acid is about 1,100% stronger than human stomach acid. And the acid breaks the proteins into amino acids. They sleep 20 hours a day, right? Dog or cat, they sleep most of the day, and their food is then passed out. So we have a different digestive system. Now, I believe we're herbivores. Herbivores means you eat plants. Some people believe we're omnivores, which means we can eat plants and animals. I'll go with that with you. For sake of negotiation, I'll give you that one. So if we're gonna eat meat, we wanna stay away from the steroids, chemicals, hormones, antibiotics, pesticides, herbicides, and tranquilizers that are in most commercial meats. So where do we find meat that doesn't have that? Organic meat. There you go. Deer. Hunt your own. Okay? So that would be a better choice. Now I'm going to give you some more things and boy stuff here. And then we've got to talk about digestion, remind me. Very important about boy stuff and digestion. If you grill your meat, and people like to grill meat, right? I used to, yeah. Used to. When you get those grill marks on the meat, those grill marks are called heterocyclic amines. Heterocyclic amines are known carcinogens. Now we as boys have to worry about prostate cancer, colon cancer, throat cancer. That's going to come with digestion, you're going to remind me about. So if we're going to grill the meat, here's some rules. Negotiation again, right, Wade? Yeah. I want you to marinate. And you can marinate it in apple cider vinegar, you can marinate it in lemon juice, but I want you to put rosemary in the marinade. It's going to reduce the carcinogens of those heterocyclic amines by about 90%.
Rosemary?
Rosemary. Just cut off some rosemary, marinate it overnight, throw a bunch of stems of rosemary in there. Can't forget rosemary, right? Or water, right? So put some, don't put your wife in there. That's a, just after plant, not rosemary. Back to Hannibal again, right, John? So rosemary will help prevent that. If you grill your meat and the fat drips down on the coals, you know that smell? It smells so good. And I agree, it smells good. Those are called polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons. Polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons are also known carcinogens. By marinating it with the rosemary, you reduce the carcinogenic levels. I'll negotiate with you. I'm reasonable, okay? But meat is tough to digest. It takes a lot of energy. The number one consumer of energy we have as humans is sex. The number two consumer of energy is digestion. The hardest thing to digest?
Meat.
Interesting. Okay? Even if we go to the Bible, there's two places Jesus ate. He ate fish, and he ate honey. No other mention of eating. And I've always found that interesting. I have no answer for that. It's a rhetorical question. But we never talked about it. At the Last Supper, he said, do this in memory of me. They don't say he actually ate. And I'm always curious about what Jesus would have eaten. And it's just a rhetorical statement, but I don't know what he would have eaten. But the fish then is different than the fish now. Okay? Because when we were kids, everything was wild caught. Now we farm raise our fish. And here's something you can do. Get some wild caught salmon. Next time in grocery store, just do this. Look for the wild caught salmon. And then look at the one that doesn't say wild caught. That'll be farm raised. Totally different marbling of the fat. It's crazy. When you look at it, you're going, wow. And the farm raised salmon are actually gray. Because they're not eating the astaxanthin, it's called, which is the krill in the small algae that gives it the pink color. So the astaxanthin is an antioxidant, and they're not eating that, so they come out gray, so we have to dye the salmon pink, because you wouldn't buy gray salmon. Well, you will buy pink salmon. So if we're going to eat fish, wild caught only. Fair enough? Mm-hmm. Reasonable?
I'm going to have to fish 5 days a week.
You're going to have Wayne, from now on, you just fish, man. That's it. I'm going to write you a note. Okay? Wayne doesn't have to go to work anymore, he just has to fish. Okay? What?
What if you can't eat
fish? If you can't eat fish, don't eat them. I mean, I don't eat fish. So. If you eat fish, that's again the if. Okay? So again, the food we ate as kids, it happened so quickly. For hundreds of years, thousands of years, everything changed in the past 50 years. And so now we have to deal with what we have. This is real life. And that's what we need to do. So we covered alcohol, we covered meat, we covered dairy, coffee, soda, artificial sweeteners, sugars, and digestion. This is going to be a biggie, okay? So what happens is anytime you eat anything, doesn't matter what it is, let's not even talk about food anymore, let's talk about how your body deals with it. You chew something, and your mouth produces salivary amylase, which breaks down complex carbohydrates into simple carbohydrates. So step number one, we have to learn something called chewing our food. I'm as guilty as you are. But when we chew it, the salivary amylase mixes with it. It goes down to your esophagus, and you have a sheet of muscle here called the diaphragm. In your diaphragm, you have a hole. It's called the lower esophageal sphincter. And it opens up and lets food pass into the small intestine, into the stomach, and then it closes. So it's a sphincter. It's kind of like your fanny. It opens and closes and lets things out. So if this sphincter opens and food drops down, and then it closes, the food is in my stomach now. My stomach's job is to mix it with digestive enzymes. So you have hydrochloric acid, which activates pepsin and pepsinogen, and pepsin and pepsinogen break the proteins into something called amino acids. Now, this is important. This is where boy stuff comes in. The amino acid tryptophan goes into my small intestine, combines with vitamin B6, and creates a chemical called 5-HTP. 5-HTP becomes serotonin. Serotonin is a chemical in my brain that helps me focus. This is why if you know somebody who has ADD, ADHD, anxiety, depression, bipolar, suicidal, they give them specific serotonin reuptake inhibitors. Drugs that help you utilize the little bit of serotonin that you have to keep the brain working. My approach that I propose is this. What if we just make more serotonin? How do we do that? We fix the digestive system. So if you have burping, gas, acid reflux, heartburn, these are signs you're not digesting your food properly. You're not digesting your food properly, you're not getting the amino acids to produce the neurotransmitters. And they do other things too, the amino acids. Tyrosine becomes dopamine. Dopamine is the neurotransmitter that gives you pleasure. So as we get older, we may have a lower sex drive, we may not tolerate children like we used to, we may get angry or sit in traffic. Many times that has to do with the serotonin levels in our brain. Where do we get serotonin from? We gotta get tyrosine from our digestive system. Glutamine becomes GABA. GABA suppresses other neurotransmitters. So when you're in pain, we can give you a drug called gabapentin, which simulates GABA in our brain to suppress our pain. Pain's still there, you just don't feel it. And then norepinephrine gives you energy. That comes from glutamine as well. So the key here is if you have acid reflux, heartburn, gas, bloating, diarrhea, constipation, chances are your stomach is pushed up against your diaphragm. We need to physically pull the stomach down away from the diaphragm. When we do that, we stimulate a nerve called the vagus nerve, V-A-G-U-S. Vagus nerve is what's called a parasympathetic nerve. Two types of nerves, one speeds you up, sympathetic, one slows you down, parasympathetics. By doing this, we're calming you down. So if you have a lot of anxiety, anger, depression, and we start acting out, maybe you become violent. Many times, we need to fix the digestive system, stimulating the parasympathetics to calm you down and giving you the amino acids to produce the neurotransmitters so you can focus and calm down. Every case I've ever seen in 30 years of practice, whether it's anxiety, depression, bipolar, any type of mental disorder, there's always an undiagnosed digestive problem. I met with a family therapist the other day. She listens to my show up in, we're nationally syndicated, but she's from Atlanta. And she came and we met for about 45 minutes. And when I explained what I just explained to you, she started crying. She said, no one's ever explained to me why my patients weren't responding better. I said, ask your patients, do they burp a lot? She goes, oh my gosh, they do. Bad gas? Yeah. Ticklish? You're protecting your digestive system. So if I poke you here and you drop down, you're protecting your digestive system. Every case I've ever had with emotional disorder is ticklish. And when we fix the emotional disorders, ticklish just goes away. They're not protecting themselves anymore. So she cried and she said, I never thought of it like this before. Why aren't you teaching in the major universities? In fact, one of the major universities up in the Atlanta area, a big hospital, a children's hospital, asked me if I would teach endocrinology at the hospital. I said, I'm a chiropractor, I'm a back cracker. What do I know about endocrinology? And he said, the way you explain things makes it so clear that the head of endocrinology said, I got it now. I understand the pituitary thyroid hypothalamus axis that you were talking about. I finally understand it now. So I want you to get that if you're having digestive problems here, this can't work. Maybe we're having troubles in our marriage. Maybe your spouse has digestive problems. Maybe you have digestive problems. It's not going to fix everything, but now you have a new tool to put in your toolbox. Maybe we should fix our digestive system. Maybe we should stop doing artificial sweeteners like aspartame, which is an excitotoxin for the brain, causing your brain to fire faster than it's supposed to. Maybe we should stop eating the high fructose corn syrup, which is preventing nitric oxide production, which is preventing both of us performing emotionally and sexually. Oh. Do you see how this all ties together for a group of men? Now you have the tools to go back and discuss with your spouse, your family, your friends. Hey, you know what? I think we're missing something. Let's try this and see if it works. And it does. Pretty cool stuff, huh? Questions, go ahead. I'm going to open a lot of questions now. Go ahead.
How do I fix my digestive system without having you guys pull my stomach down?
I have this. I have acid reflux. I have heartburn. I burp a lot. Yeah, but most people do. 85% of my patients have digestive problems. 15% lie. It's 100%. Wayne. There's no way to fix it yourself. But if you go to my website, I have an article on it called Gastroesophageal Reflux Disease. It is by far the number one searched article on my website. We get hits from all over the world. And that by far passes everything. It's about three paragraphs, real simple, and explains how we do that technique. I wish I could tell you how to do it yourself, but you can't. Because when I have it, I can't do it myself. I have to grab one of my doctors and have them do it. But read the article. Where do you live?
Atlanta.
Atlanta, okay, so you can come see us if you want. But I have people from other cities, their doctors call me up and say, can you talk me through this? And I have to talk them through it. Yes.
I have a son with a syndrome called Prader-Willi.
Mm-hmm.
And this syndrome coincides with bipolarism and the eating disorder.
Yes.
So are you saying that by changing his diet, that may help his syndrome?
Yes. He has a son who has a bipolar disorder. And the answer is a resounding yes. Because if I want to plant tomatoes, I'm going somewhere with this, I have to have good soil, I have to have tomato seeds, I have to have water, I have to have sunlight, I have to have the right amount of everything to make the tomatoes grow. How can we make his brain grow if we don't give him all the raw materials to make it happen? Okay? And you'll notice if you give him certain things like sugar, he's going to be off the chart. When you give him other foods, he'll calm down. And I'm going to talk about some supplements, too, that I'm going to recommend everybody take, but I'll cover that in a second. Okay? You got a question over here? Yeah.
I noticed on your runner-ups, you got pickles and sauerkraut. I thought vinegar and vinaigrettes were supposed to be good.
Pickles and sauerkraut, they're great for you if you make them yourself. If you don't make them yourself, they usually have nitrates in it, and nitrates are carcinogenic. Now, there's good and bad nitrates, by the way. So, for example, here's a little boy tip for you. If we're going to eat beets, or the cool thing now is beet powder. You can get some beet powder. And you eat the beets, the saliva in your mouth activates the nitrates in the beets to create nitric oxide, vasodilator, nature's little blue pill. And it's funny, a friend of mine is a nutritional consultant for the Olympic skating team. And he says when he goes to the camps now, beet juice everywhere. They're on their shirts, it's on their mouth, it's in their hair. These kids are sucking down beet juice because it's a legal vasodilator. They can get tested for it, there's nothing wrong with it. So if we're going to do pickles and sauerkraut, I recommend you make it yourself. And here's the other reason why, too. When you buy it, it's heated. And when you heat it to pasteurize, you destroy the good bacteria. And you want those good bacteria. Because those good bacteria, 99% of the DNA in your body is not yours. It's bacteria. 1% human DNA. Wow. Okay? So we have to take care of those good bacteria. And we kill it by eating meats that are loaded with steroids and antibiotics. We take antibiotics. It's in the water, fluorine and chlorine. I don't know how much time we have. I can do a whole lecture on water if you want. But fluorine and chlorine kill off the good bacteria. So that's why making your own pickles and sauerkraut is the best thing you can do. It's probably one of the best foods you can eat by far. Okay? That's a great question. Yes?
You just talked about water. What's the best part of water to drink out there?
Water in this order. Distilled is the best. It's hard to do. It's expensive. Reverse osmosis is going to be your next best. Okay? And here's a little fun thing you can do. It's a little preview of my new book coming out. If you take a glass of tap water, take two glasses. Make it clear. You don't have to clear glasses. Two glasses. Go get a pool testing kit that tests for chlorine. Mm-hmm. Test the water, you'll see there's chlorine in the water. It's in tap water, okay? Take the other one, put your hand in it for 60 seconds. Take your hand out, test it for chlorine. There'll be no chlorine in that water. Where'd the chlorine go?
Absorbs
in your skin. Now we talked about your skin absorbing things. So every time you take a shower, you're absorbing about 8 glasses of chlorine, 8 glasses of water, the chlorine content, every time you take a hot shower. So that's why on my website we actually have shower filters. Relatively inexpensive, you can put it on your shower, and we have counter filters for your sink as well. Ideally, you want to get a whole house water filter, but they're expensive, $3,000-$4,000 if you want a good one. But at least have a filter in your kitchen and in your shower. That would be the minimum. So reverse osmosis is something that's practical. If you have a filter like that under your sink, that's the kind of water you can drink. As far as bottled water goes, the key word there is bottle, not plastic. Because plastic containers have xenoestrogen, xeno meaning foreign. Xenophobia is fear of foreigners, right? Xenoestrogen is a foreign estrogen that gets into our bodies, boys. We don't want more estrogen, we want less estrogen, right? And it's messing with our hormones. So if you're going to drink bottled water that comes in a plastic container, if it ever tastes funny, don't drink it. You ever drink that? You drink some water and goes,
That's a confirmation. I was told that 3 days ago.
It's a confirmation, man. Yeah, so what I do is I have a filter at my house, whole house filter, and then I just fill up my glass containers or stainless steel containers, and I drink that. Or if I have a hard plastic container, that's okay, as long as it's not being exposed to heat.
And you say hard plastic?
Hard plastic, not soft. The softer the plastic, the more it's going to leach toxins into the water.
BPA-free.
BPA-free, there you go, right. Yes?
So does that mean, like for me, I'm very, when I buy my bottle of water, I always leave it in my car, and so that's a very bad thing.
Not anymore, you know.
I'm a truck driver, so a lot of time I got a thick plastic cup.
Sure.
So what I do is when I go to Quick Trip, I get the ice, but I get the hot water. I use the hot water instead of getting the drink water. Is that better?
I wouldn't put hot water in plastic, no. Okay? Plastic, it'll melt it.
No, I'm saying no. What I do is I get ice, but I'd rather have that hot water,
same water
than the water from the... Right over there with
the probably the same. The ice is made with the same chlorinated water, yeah. And here's a fun thing for you. That if you ever buy, go home today, look on your side of tube toothpaste. Commercial toothpaste. There'll be a warning on that side of tube toothpaste. You know what it says? Harmful if swallowed. It's toothpaste! Because the fluoride is a poison. When it gets into the body. Now, fluoride on your tooth, I'm not going to argue this point. If you put fluoride, like a dentist puts fluoride on your tooth, I wouldn't do it. But if a dentist puts fluoride on your tooth, it may help prevent cavities. I don't think it does, but I'm not going to argue that point. But it doesn't do a darn thing when it gets into your small intestine. When you drink it, that's when it becomes a poison. And that's why the toothpaste says harmful if swallowed. I never use fluoride toothpaste. Okay, yes?
Two questions. One, alkaline water, how is that? And then the beets, my wife boils them, and they're organic beets.
Sure.
So she boils them and then cuts them up and puts them in the salad.
Perfect.
Can I drink the water?
Yes, drink the water that the organic beets are boiled in. Eat the beets like crazy, boys. You're going to be very happy, trust me. Okay, your wife will be sending me flowers. And as far as alkaline water, and that happens sometimes. It's so funny. In the office, I'll get a fruit basket. I'll be like, oh, that's actually bro. But the alkaline water, that's a new trend right now. I'm not against the alkaline water. What I'm against is you're not eating enough. You're eating too much acid. If you're eating a good diet, your good diet consists of fruits, vegetables, nuts, and seeds. If you're eating a good diet, you don't need the alkaline water. Why alkalize something that's already alkaline? Okay, so, yes?
With regards to the beets, what about the sugar content? Are you trading off of a balance here?
You're trading off of a balance. There is some sugar content in the beets, but you're not eating sugar beets. You're eating the other type of beets. Okay. But the sugar content is there, but the fiber, and this is a key for us boys, again, fiber is going to slowly push the food through our colon, and you get a slow release of sugar. This is why if you're diabetic, I did a report, I was a Channel 11 News up in Atlanta, I was a news on-air reporter for a while, and I did a report, and it was from the Journal of Diabetes, whatever, the American Diabetes Foundation, and it said if you eat, I think, don't quote me on the exact number, 68 to 72 grams of fiber a day, you can reduce or eliminate the need for most medications. That's a big statement for diabetics, type 2 diabetics. Endocrinologist called up the station, you don't know what you're talking about, you're just a chiropractor, I'm an endocrinologist. So I called him up, and this is before emails, I said, let me fact you the article from your journal. I didn't make it up, I quoted your journal. Never heard from him again. So, and I thought, why am I reading his journal and he's not? But I read constantly. So fiber is going to be the key here, because fiber pushes everything through the colon and gives you a slow release of energy. The other thing fiber does is when you have excess hormones, it gets dumped into your small intestine. If you don't have high fiber, they get reabsorbed. So it flushes out the hormones as well. So you should be going to the bathroom, normal bowel function, 2 to 3 times a day. Not a week, not a year, a day. 2 to 3 times a day is normal bowel function. If it's not, you either have a spasm colon or you just don't have enough fiber and water as well. You gotta get those bowels moving. You'll lose weight, you'll feel great, your energy level will increase, your testosterone will probably go up, your sex drive will increase, your brain function will increase. All that happens when you eat good food. It's just that simple. Yes?
Dehydrated fruit.
The what?
Dehydrated fruit.
Dehydrated fruit is good, just make sure it doesn't have a lot of sugar added to it, or nitrates. Sometimes they have nitrates on it. So if you eat dry fruit, it shouldn't be pretty. If it's fluffy and soft and pretty, that's not the kind you want. You want dried and ugly. That's the good kind of fruit. But if it has nitrates or excess sugar, you don't want to eat it. Okay? Yeah?
You mentioned coffee, but you didn't say anything about tea.
If you're gonna drink tea, it's okay. It's a better choice. In the world of caffeine, coffee's up here. Down here we have something called mate, M-A-T-E. Mateine, mate has something called mateine, which is essentially caffeine. So as you're coming off your coffee, if you want to reduce down and not cut it out altogether, go to mate, then black tea, then green tea, then white tea. So if you're going to drink tea, I'm okay with that. Try to do organic. If you can do it without the caffeine, there's tons of teas out there that don't have caffeine in it. I grow peppermint in my backyard. It grows like a weed. I go out there, cut it, dry it out, makes the most amazing tea. Get a French press, put it in there, most amazing tea in the world. And it's free. It grows like a weed, as you know, right, Wade? It's like, you can't kill it. And we talked about acid. So I said, how can I alkalize the body? And I thought, well, wheatgrass, barley grass, alfalfa grass, these are all alkalizing to the system. So I created two supplements that I take every day, many times, twice a day. It's called Dr. Joe's Super Greens and Dr. Joe's Essential Source. They're powders, I mix them together. I'll have Walton tell you how good they are in a second. And I drink them every day. Now, if I'm going to do a radio show, if I'm going to do a lecture, if I'm going to have a date, if I'm going on a hike, work it out, I'll take it for a second time. And it's the minimum core nutrient your body needs to function. So that's what I recommend for everybody to take, Super Greens and Essential Source. Then I'll customize a plan if you need more, but that's the minimum. Now, I brought some with me today. So if you want to get them, They'll be in the back. Laura will have them. And if you get the Super Greens, the Essential Source, I'm going to give you a free copy of my book called Eating Right for the Health of It. And the first half of the book tells you how to change your diet, and the second half of the book is hundreds of recipes. So if you want to get them, that's great. And we can take credit cards and cash and checks and, I don't know, whatever. Trade you out chickens. The chicken plant. But they're in the back there if you want. I'll even sign the book. Now, here's the deal. I'll sign the book for you, but I don't want you selling it on eBay. They sell on eBay for $80, okay? So I don't want to... Sign 12, please.
95. I got for mine.
You got to get 95, okay? Yeah, no.
I was listening to someone speak like around 3 weeks ago, and they mentioned something like called Vita-4. I don't even know what it is.
Vita-4?
Vita-4.
I don't know what that is, yeah. Okay. Mine's the best. It's problem solved. So, because it's everything in it. It's all, it's a scoop. It's easy. It's quick. It transports. And so it goes on an airplane. You can't bring fruits and vegetables on an airplane.
What do you mix it with?
I mix it with coconut milk, but you can use almond milk. You use water if you want, but I like it with coconut milk. Okay? Yes?
Fried foods.
Fried foods. When you fry a food, it creates something called a hydrogenated oil. The oil changes its molecular structure, and that's what margarine is. So the fried foods, the hydrogenated oils, are the number one cause of heart disease in this country. If you're going to fry, I'll negotiate with you. Remember, I'll negotiate everything. You have to use an oil that doesn't break down under high heat. Coconut oil would be your best choice. Okay? Now, that being said, most fried foods, we use corn oil, soybean oil. Those are very high in omega-6 fatty acids. Talk about prostate problems, you got to cut out all your omega-6 fatty acids because they cause inflammation. And that's what prostate is, inflamed. So no corn oil, soybean oil, a vegetable oil. If you're going to cook, avocado oil or coconut oil is going to be your best. Avocado is a lot more expensive.
Peanut oil?
Peanut oil? No. Very high in omega-6 fatty acids.
What about palm oil?
Palm oil is okay.
Olive oil
is okay, but you can't heat it for very long. Okay? Yes?
Find a lot of after you eat, it's like sleep.
Yes, it's what you're eating. Number one consumer of energy is sex. Number two is digestion. So try this, and this is a perfect way to do this. Try eating mostly fruits, vegetables, nuts, and seeds. And if you go to my website, by the way, if you type in your email address on the bottom right-hand corner, I'll send you a link to a lecture I did called, So What Can I Eat? And my website has hundreds of hours of radio shows on. It's all free. I'll probably put this video on my website. It's on my YouTube channel, so you can watch it if you want to watch it again. Bring it home to your families. It's all free. You can send me questions if you want through the website. I have articles there. It's all free. But try this. Try eating right for 1 week. That's it. How about 1 day? Make it easy, 1 day. So have mostly fruits, vegetables, nuts, and seeds. And I'll tell you what I eat in a day. The next day, have yourself a couple slices of pizza. And you'll fall right to sleep. Okay? There's 26,960 days in the average life. That's it. Take your age, multiply by 365, minus 26,963. That's all you got left. That ain't good, is it? But if you want to add 8 years, how about a bonus? 8 years? Freebie? 8 years of life? Cut out dairy products. People don't consume dairy products, live an average of eight years longer. Want to add 11 years? Cut out all animal products. 11 years longer. Cut out all animal products. 11 years extended quality life.
So that's vegan.
That's vegan. So it's up to you. But if you're tired, it's what you're eating, I promise you. So if you have a salad for lunch, okay, just have a plant-based lunch. Have salad, have collard greens, make sure they're not cooked in beef fat. You can have some cooked and raw vegetables for lunch. If you want to have something heavy, maybe some beans, you'll be buzzing right through the day. The patients I see at 8:30 in the morning get the same treatment that I see at 6 o'clock at night. And many times after I work all day, nonstop, I'll go out and give a lecture. I'll go do radio shows. I ain't young anymore. This is how I want to live, though. It's not worth it to me to have a fried chicken and give up a day of my life. It's not worth it. So, yeah, another question.
I was going to say, as far as salads go, you recommend making your own salad versus one?
You can make your own salad. I prefer to do that. You can buy pre-washed organic salads now, real cheap. With salad dressings, I recommend raw organic apple cider vinegar as part of your dressing. Raw organic apple cider vinegar, another boy tip. Raw organic apple cider vinegar is amazing because it gives you good bacteria for your colon, it alkalizes your system, and it stimulates your digestive enzymes. So that's the kind I'd recommend. But stay away from the blue cheeses and the creamy ones. Try to stay more basic on your salad dressings. Yeah?
I was going to ask, how should you drink the
Apple cider vinegar.
I don't like apple cider vinegar, but I do it anyway. So you can drink it straight. You can mix it with water. I like to use it as part of my salad dressing, because this way it's not as strong. But raw organic, make sure. It's really expensive. It's about $4 for a bottle this big, okay? It'll be the best investment you ever made. So I do the Super Greens, the Essential Source, and the apple cider vinegar are just winners. Now what you can do is put it next to your bed in the morning with some water or some stevia mixed in. As soon as you wake up, chug it. Man, you get energy like that. It's crazy how much energy you get.
Apple cider vinegar?
Raw organic apple cider vinegar, yeah, okay.
You ever heard of Bragg's vinegar?
Bragg's, that's the kind, yeah, okay. That's the one I want, yeah. Never heard of it. We can talk about it afterwards. I'll look there for you, okay? Yes?
Could you talk about the use of the hydrogen-based mouthwash?
Like hydrogen peroxide?
Yeah, its relation to bacteria.
Yeah, hydrogen peroxide, you can wash your mouth out with that. That's fine. It's antiviral, antibacterial, and antifungal. A really cool thing, we can go off for hours, by the way, boys, just so you know, I don't run out of stuff. So, get yourself organic coconut oil and take about a teaspoon, between a teaspoon and a tablespoon, swish it around in your mouth for up to 20 minutes. You have gum disease, infections, it's amazing. Now, I'm not, coconut oil, extra virgin organic coconut oil. Now, I have an old root canal up here, it hurts. Every now and then I've been to 5 different dentists, like nothing you can do about it. So I swish around with coconut oil, and it gets my gums strong, it'll wipe out infections, it's amazing. Now, I'm not saying do this and not go to the dentist, this is try this first. Hydrogen peroxide works, the coconut oil works even better. And then spit it out. Yeah, make sure it's organic, make sure it's not the cheap stuff hydrogenated, but it works well, okay? Coconut oil is amazing, another boy tip. We got boys going on here. It's a great lubricant for everything. Because as we get older, our ladies get older. And they don't, their estrogen levels drop, their lubrication drops, they become less romantic because it's not comfortable for them. Coconut oil is an amazing, safe lubricant. Because a lot of times you use the commercial lubricants, they have chemicals in it that will mess with their hormones again and mess with your hormones. So coconut oil is an amazing lubricant for just about anything.
Yes. Just
drink the coconut oil. Absolutely. 2 tablespoons a day minimum. Yep.
Just a couple more questions, guys.
Okay, we're running out of time. Okay. All right, so if you want to get the supplements, you want to come up and tell them about supplements, Walt? Okay, if you want to get supplements in the book, it's back there. Laura will get them for you. Walt will tell you what he does. If I have any more questions, I'll be in the back. You learn something today?
Yeah.
Thanks, guys. All right, hold on. One second for Walt.
Thank you, Dr. Joe. I've been using that religiously, I must say, and I have found that my energy level, to the question of my younger son here, he asked me, how do you keep going? He was born when I was 24 years old, and he's asking me, how do you keep going? Well, I can testify that this product works. I mix it with almond milk. I like unsweetened almond milk, and I mix it with almond milk. I also use the coconut oil for gargle and the hydrogen peroxide. And I've been treated by Dr. Joe for now about a year. And there were some symptoms that I had. And for instance, my blood pressure was extremely high to the point where my doctor was saying I need to be admitted in a hospital right away. And I went through all the tests, paid several $1,000 to get tests administered, and nothing worked. I've been listening to him on Sunday nights on my drive to Norcross for quite a while. I said, I'm gonna check this guy out. I went out over there and he did the x-ray and found that my spine was 12 degrees off. It was turning to the left instead of being straight. My neck was 17 degrees off. And they started the adjustment process, okay? My blood pressure came down because I had no problems that they could diagnose, just that the pressure was high. And being a commercial driver, that hindered me from actually doing what I needed to do. So my blood pressure came down. My prostate, my PSA was high. That came down without any medication. So I can testify that the things that you heard here today actually do work. And I believe when we read Genesis, God gave Adam a garden, right? Fruits and vegetables. And even the sacrifice that Abel made to the Lord, it wasn't about eating the meat. It was actually burnt. And as you say, I believe we're herbivores. Somewhere along the line, we were taught to be omnivores. But if we would just adjust our diets, follow some of what he said today, even some of it, you'll see the change. Now, he's got the supplements back there. There are two different supplements. And as he mentioned, he's a negotiator too. I am one too. If you buy both supplements, you get the book for free, which is what kind of value?
About $17,
$18. $18 value. Okay. Thank you, guys. Thank you, Dr. Joe.
Also, if you ever want to come see me as a patient, if you're in the Atlanta area, we have offices in Atlanta and in Duluth. You can just fill out the survey, let us know what you thought of today's workshop. Just say, I want to make an appointment, and one of my staff will give you a call. We'll set you up a time for a free consultation. I'll be more than happy to work with you. We accept most major medicals, car accident cases, Medicare cases. It's very easy to be a patient in my offices, yeah. Okay?
Thank you,
Matt.
Thanks, guys. When we get down here, we're going to head over to the dining room for lunch.
What?
There's salads over there.